but it is the knowledge that determine. And therefore, in these verses, Krishna wants to talk about both a grihastha jnani as well as a sannyasi jnani. And he wants to say that grihastha jnani is also liberated in spite of a busy life. Sannyasi jnani is also liberated in spite of his, what you call, freedom from all the activity. Therefore, in the 20th verse which we were seeing in the last class, Krishna said, Nitya triptaha nirashrayaha grihasthaha jnani. So this grihastha jnani is ever fulfilled not because he has completed the family duties, but because he finds the fulfillment within himself or herself. There is no question of fulfillment after completing the duties, because in grihastha ashrama, duties will come wave after wave, like the waves in the ocean. Alayonji samudra snanam panna mudiyadu solra madri. There is no question of completing the duty and thereafterwards finding rest. Therefore, rest has to be found not by completing the duties, but in spite of duties. And this is what a grihastha has done, and therefore he is nitya triptaha. And therefore only nirashrayaha. The children's future is not going to decide his peace of mind. And therefore nirashrayaha, he will contribute his best for the growth of the children. But what happens and my peace of mind, I don't want to make a connection. And therefore nirashrayaha doesn't depend upon people, doesn't depend upon events. And therefore karmani abhipravrittaha abhi. Even though he is very extremely intensely active, naiva kinchit karoti saha. He is as good as free from actions, because those actions do not become a burden for him. So he is, as somebody nicely said, when the shoe fits your feet, you don't feel the presence of the shoes. Inga shoe podirukkeena theriyum. When do you feel the presence of the shoes? When it does not fit properly, then all the time it draws your attention. Inge irukke, inge irukke solli. In fact, like you should be like mullah. You know what mullah used to do? He used to have a very, very tight shoes, it seems. Then somebody asked, why are you wearing such a shoe? He said, for getting that enjoyment of removal in the evening. Okay, if you are such a person, that's a different thing. So when something is fit, then you don't feel the burden. For a jnani, karma is not a burden at all. Up to this we saw in the last class, continuing. Nirashiryata chittatman tyakta sarva parigraha shariram kevalam karma kurvannapnoti kilbisham. So in this verse, Krishna talks about a sannyasi jnani. So a person who does not have any possession wife, children, bank balance, etc. He is a monk. And Krishna says, that person also is a free person. And therefore he says, Tyakta sarva parigraha. So this sannyasi jnani has renounced all his possession. Parigraha means all possessions, not only things but even relationships. So all of them he has given up, which means he is in chaturtha ashrama. And nirashi, after giving up those things, If a person is going to miss them, then the giving up is of no use. Krishna already talked about such a person in the fourth chapter. Karmendriyani sanyamya ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan vimudhatma. After physically renouncing pleasures, if a person is going to think of them, or feel jealous of those people, valaku ethra nanna veed irukku, wife iruka, kolandigal irukku, coffee vela valaki kudikalam. So if he is going to miss them, as long as you miss those things, renunciation is suppression. Therefore renunciation is meaningful only when I don't miss what I have renounced. And therefore Krishna here says, this monk or sannyasi, nirashi, he does not lack anything in life. And yata chitta atma, and the one who has mastered his body mind complex by sadhana. Because if a person has to give up comforts in life, he has to make his body fit for that. Otherwise, if the body is used to those comforts, AC liye dam paduthundu palakam solluthu sonna, then even if you are mentally prepared, the body is not ready. And therefore, the one who wants to take sannyasa, he must have physical fitness as well as mental fitness. And therefore, yata chitta atma. Here the word atma means body, shariram, not Sachidananda atma, but the body. And chitta means mind. Both of them are mastered. And such a person, what karma he does? Shariram kevalam karma kurvan. So since he does not have any family or possession, he doesn't have any responsibility also. Possession and responsibility go together. And that's why we say, grihasthashrama has got an advantage also, a disadvantage also. Sannyasa ashrama has got an advantage also, a disadvantage also. What is the advantage of grihasthashrama? There is security. In fact, most of the people want grihasthashrama and children for what purpose? Vayasana kalathile oru neram oru velaki jalam kudukkaradhukku irpaala va kudupaala maatala adu vera vishayam. There is a fond hope that the children will take care. And therefore possession of a house, bank balance, children, etc., there is an advantage of security, but the disadvantage is you have the responsibility of taking care of them. So security is advantage, responsibility is disadvantage. What about sannyasa ashrama? No responsibility. Wife paathukanamna wife illa irundha thana paathukiradhu. Children you have to educate, no children at all. How to invest properly, seeing the interest na enala irundha thana invest pandrathukku. There is nothing to invest. So therefore, there are no responsibilities at all. But at the same time, there is a disadvantage. What is that? There is no security. A sannyasi gives himself at the hands of the Lord. Ananyas chintayantomam edanav paryupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyaham. That is a different LIC. Adum yogakshemam vahamyaham da. So sannyasi has got that LIC. Grihastha has got Mount Road yogakshemam vahamyaham LIC. Therefore, every ashrama has got plus and minus points. Therefore, don't compare the ashrama. Learn to find security within yourself. And therefore, shariram kevalam karma. Since he doesn't have any family responsibilities or even social responsibilities. So, sannyasa ashrama is a civil death. So, therefore, he doesn't have even power to vote. He is not supposed to take part even in these duties. No duty at all. Because if I have to vote, then there is a judge who is, nobody is better, that is a different thing. But at least he has to make a comparison. In the coalition, vote podanama, and the coalition, vote podanama. All these are distractions. Therefore, sannyasi doesn't have even social duties. Then what karma he does? He has got only one duty. What is that? Bhagavan has given a body to him. And he is the trustee of this body. And therefore, until the prarabdha is over, he has to take care of the body as Lord's property. And therefore, Krishna says, shariram kevalam karma. For the maintenance of the body, whatever karma is required, snanam, vastram, bhiksha, etc., karma kurvan. Kurvan, and again, bhiksha means you should not choose. Okay, athle irundha enak enak ada panni podu dosha panni podu illan sollam. But here he cannot ask bhavati doshai dehi illan sollavidadu. Bhavati bhikshan dehi kadachada shavadanam. No complaints, no comparison. So, shariram kevalam karma kurvan kilbisham na apnoti. He does not get any karma phalam. Kilbisham means literally papam. Here papam means karma phalam. Since he does not have a ego, karma will not produce punyam also. Karma will not produce papam also for him. So this is a sannyasi jnani. Continuing. Yadriccha labha santushtaha.
Yadriccha labha santushtaha.
Dvandvatito
vimatsaraha.
Samasiddhavasiddhaucha.
Samasiddhavasiddhaucha.
Krittvapinanibadhyate.
Krittvapinanibadhyate.
So this verse can be taken as either a grihastha jnani sloka or a sannyasi jnani parasloka. In both ways we can interpret. Shankaracharya takes this verse as the description of a sannyasi jnani. But this can be taken as a grihastha jnani also. I will take it this verse as a grihastha jnani's description. Because here majority path pannanum alliya. So therefore, I will interpret in that way. Both are okay. And what is his attitude in life? Yadriccha labha santushtaha. he welcomes whatever happens in his life as a result of his karma. So, yadrichha labha santushtaha, satisfied with whatever comes to him as a result of his action. Because we should remember that the events in our life are not totally controlled by us. This is a very important lesson that we have to remember throughout the life. My future is not totally controlled by me. But we should be very careful, because we tend to go to two extreme. There are one set of people who claim that I can order my future and I can decide my future, I can totally control my future. This is one extreme, the arrogant type of people, and they will talk like that until they get kuttu from the Lord. No human being can claim that. Even Bhagavan, when he came as avatara, he could not totally decide what is going to happen. So one extreme is overconfident. Then the second extreme is the fatalistic type, who say that nothing is under my control. I don't have any control at all with regard to my future. This is the other extreme. One takes 100% responsibility, another takes 0% responsibility. Gita says both extremes are wrong. Then what is the right attitude? I am one of the contributory factors with regard to my future, and I am a very powerful, very important contributory factor with regard to my future. I cannot totally decide, but I can influence my future. Then if I don't have the total control, then what are the other factors which will control? All the other factors put together we call Daivam. Because the other factors are too numerous to enumerate. Right from weather onwards, right from a war somewhere onwards, everything can influence today's condition. As somebody said, you cannot pluck a flower without disturbing a star. That means the whole world is interconnected, and therefore the number of factors that will determine my future is so numerous that instead of enumerating them, we have put all the extraneous factors into one huge bag, and we call it Daivam or Prarabdham or Ishvara Icha, God's will. And therefore, what should be my attitude? I contribute my best. And once I have contributed my best, I prepare my mind to receive any type of result. And this attitude is called yadrichha labha santushtaha. Yadrichha means whatever happens as karma phalam. In that labha santushtaha, and some commentators read this word twice, yadrichha labha santushtaha, yadrichha alabha santushtaha. So whatever comes also he accepts, and whatever doesn't come also equally he accepts. So yadrichha labha santushtaha. Okay, but again we should be very careful with regard to these things. Whatever comes as karma phalam, it is according to the law of the Lord that I have to accept. That does not mean that we should not work for improving the situation. If the failure happens, I have to accept it because it has happened and therefore it is choiceless. But at the same time, with regard to the next result, I have got control and therefore I can do whatever has to be done. Therefore, accept the present, work for the future. Accept the present, work for the future. So, worry cannot change the present. Worry cannot change the future also. Present requires acceptance. Future requires hard work. This is the simple philosophy of Gita. Present, including past, requires acceptance. Future requires hard work. Both of them do not require worry. Therefore, Krishna said, Ashochyan Anvashochastvam. Arjuna, you are worrying because nothing deserves worry. And therefore, Yadrichha Labha Santushtaha Andvandvatitaha. One who is beyond the pairs of opposites, which Krishna described in the second chapter, Dukheshu Anudvignamanaha Sukheshu Vigataspriha Vitaraga Bhayakrodhaha Stitadhir Muniruchyate Yas Sarvatra Anabhisnehaha Tattat Prapya Shubha Ashubham Nabhinandati Nadveshti. Life is nothing but facing a series of pairs of opposites. And dvandvatitaha means the one who has gone beyond the pairs of opposite. Then the next question is, what do you mean by gone beyond the pairs of opposite? Gone beyond means, will he go to the upper Mahdi or something? In fact, you cannot physically